Listen. B. Listen to a radio program with body language expert Dr. Susan Madison and complete the sentences below.
Good afternoon. Today with us we have a special guest, Dr. Susan Madison, who is a body language expert. Welcome, Susan.
Hello.
Now, you're going to talk to us about the messages we send out to other people, not through words, but through movements and changes in our bodies, right?
Yes, body language is a very important form of communication. Reading body language signals can be a helpful way to understand one another better. It certainly is very useful for parents who worry and complain about not communicating well with their teenage children, because what their mouth doesn't say, their body will.
So, what signs do we need to be looking out for?
Well, this non-verbal form of communication consists of body posture, gestures, facial expressions, and eye movement. Let me give you an example. Slumped body posture. Standing up straight shows that a person is feeling confident and comfortable. But if your teenager is walking in a slumped position, he or she may well be feeling self-conscious. You know, shy and not feeling sure of him or herself. Unhappy or a bit down.
So slumped body posture is something negative?
No, no, don't get me wrong. It's just an indication. He or she might also be feeling okay, but is just thinking about something. It depends on what's normal for your teen.
Now, I often see teenagers with their hands in their pockets. What does that mean?
It could mean lots of things. They could be nervous, worried, bored, or hiding something. Of course, sometimes it is just a good way to keep your hands warm when it's cold.
Of course. So there is a lot to think about when trying to understand body language.
Yes, and I haven't even told you about eye movement yet. It is very common for teenagers to not want to make eye contact with adults. If they are not able to look you straight in the eye, this can mean that their self-confidence has not developed yet.
Isn't it also a sign of lying?
Yes, often when a person knows that what they are saying is false, they look down as they don't want to look at the other person in the eye. Another important sign is if they look up and to the left as they are talking to you. This is a common sign of not telling the truth.
Very useful.
Well, yes, but we must be careful. Most body language experts say that we need to look for at least 4 body language signals that mean the same emotion before we come to any conclusions. So, in this case, apart from eye movement, we should look at the person's hand movements, as they can tell.